NASA's Artemis moon rocket arriving at the launch pad in Cape Canaveral, Florida. The capsule will fly around the moon for a couple of weeks before heading back down to Earth. News 11's Angela Huddy spoke with the St. Louis Science Center about the new mission and our town's important history to lunar exploration.
The Artemis I moon rocket has arrived at the launch pad at Kennedy Space Center for liftoff on a journey around the moon.
The new SLS rocket is ready down in Florida, and it is the largest rocket that we've ever made as people. It is even bigger than the Saturn V and the Apollo days.
NASA announced Wednesday that the mission is set to begin August 29th. The unmanned capsule will fly around the moon for a couple of weeks before heading back to Earth.
And if everything goes well, it won't be very long now before Artemis 2 and 3, when we're going to get to see humans go back to the moon.
This test launch with a newly developed spacecraft, Orion, will determine if we're ready for larger and longer-term human missions.
There's still so much we need to learn, not only about the moon, but this will be a great testing ground for other long-term space missions, the type of technology and experience we'll need to go to Mars and then someday beyond.
NASA would never have gotten to the moon without St. Louis. The McDonnell Aircraft Corporation created space capsules for the Mercury and Gemini missions, which led to the technology needed to land a man on the moon.
The heritage of contributing to human spaceflight still continues with Boeing, and they are working on several aspects of the SLS rocket that, without them, we wouldn't be doing what we're doing now.
To see actual Mercury and Gemini spacecraft and to learn more about St. Louis's history in space exploration, visit the McDonnell Planetarium at the St. Louis Science Center Thursdays through Monday. Reporting from Forest Park, I'm Angela Huddy, News 11.